this island is a very small island, only 34 square kilometers big. The main church, yeah, is from the 11th century. It's a Byzantine church. Also, the refectory is also a very big building. It's also from the 11th century active. And we are the monks now. Yeah? They sleep because they have to get up very early in the morning. The holy service takes in the morning 4 hours, from 3 o'clock in the morning till 7 o'clock in the morning. Yeah? So, and then they have to go to bed, of course, they have to work. What are they doing? Some of them are painters. They paint beautiful icons. Some are restorators. Some others work in the library. This monastery has a very, very famous library. Only the manuscripts of this library are more than 1,000. And the oldest is the famous Codex Purpureus. Is about 1,500 years old, the third oldest manuscript in the world. Later on in the museum, I show you there are 2 pages of this manuscript. Yeah? Manuscript made of leather, of parchment. So.
Now that's the monk's room.
Thank you.
Seven golden candlesticks symbolize these churches, these cities: Pergamon, Ephesus, Smyrna. The two keys symbolize the victory of Jesus Christ over the death and Hades. On the left, on the right, you see seven angels. Are the seven guardian angels of the seven. Wrote here according to the tradition, according to the tradition, the book of the Revelation, the book of the Apocalypse. So, and something else, I pretend to this place, he wanted to be alone, to pray. He used to lay down and rest here. You see a niche in the rock, that was the pillow of St. John. He used to put his head there. He used this niche as a pillow, according to the tradition. And here, there is another smaller niche in the rock, that this was the support of St. John. He was old, he couldn't get up very easily. He used to put his hand inside to get up. Yeah?